And KD famously went on to CJ McCollum's podcast, and he had some words for CJ and the future of the Blazers that I'm not sure he's going to be so proud of heading into this series. Let's listen.
You know you guys aren't going to win a championship.
Bro, we have the team. We have the capabilities. Anything is possible. We can win a championship, bro.
I mean, let's be honest.
Bro, we can win a championship. Anything is possible.
I just need to, I need more. I mean, I like y'all. I like the two. I like y'all too. You're hard to stop. But, I mean, come on.
So, Bruce, what's more disrespectful? Disrespecting CJ's team and his teammates on his own podcast, or disrespecting CJ's team and his teammates on his own podcast while eating some barbecue potato chips?
That, I think the barbecue, and it was a hoagie he was eating.
A hoagie.
Come on.
I mean, Bill Cosby.
I mean, come on now.
Now, it's you know, this is the fine line with athletes and doing things in season, or being a current player and doing these things, because it can create controversy. Mm-hmm. There was a time I wanted to do a radio show in San Antonio, and I remember Tom James, our PR guy, he was like, okay, we just running by Pop first, and Pop called me into his office. He said, do what you want, but it doesn't work. And I'm like, why doesn't it work? I'm thinking, I'm going to say, why?
You're great, set myself up for, you know, after my
oh
career.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. No, well, I hadn't even gotten that far, but When he said it, it was just his tone. The part that did it for me was when he said, do what you want, but it doesn't work for you. And I'm like, it doesn't work. Because now I'll have to be critical against guys, and I'm going to play those guys, and they can say, yeah, Bruce said this. I'm going at his skull.
Yep.
I don't need any other stuff being thrown on top of my plate when it comes to trying to defend some of the top guys I was playing against.
Well, let's take a look at who's going to be defending who in this series, which I am so excited for. You look at the matchups, you know, between the Blazers and the Warriors. A lot more firepower on the Warriors, but I could see this happening. I could see this going long.
Long? You say long?
Yeah.
Okay. What's long to you?
Six games. Depends on when KD gets back. So you're saying
KD,
there's no world in which the Trailblazers
don't bring KD back.
Wow.
Because it's going to throw off the chemistry. He's coming off an injury. He hasn't played game speed anything. Even when you practice in postseason, that's practice. All right, guys, come in. We'll go over there.
Bring KD back for the NBA Finals and have him work himself back on the biggest stage in the game?
I don't think you do it now. But again, I haven't thought.
What if you're down 1-2 after game three?
1-2, he's not going to save you. Because he's injured. He's not 100. He's not the same KD that walked off the court that night.
Huh.
See, he has to get accustomed to utilizing his body again. His calf, he jumps to shoot jump shot. He posts up. He's going to have to get position. So, trusting that in that situation when you guys are down, no, you have to come up with a grand scheme during the course of that time playing without him, which can be done.
Interesting. What do you expect from this series quickly?
I expect great basketball. I think they kind of mirror one another as far as the ball movement and guards that are creative. I think Portland has the more creative point guard and two guard, but you have Steph and you have Clay, and Clay has a different creativity to his style of play. It's right up on you, think you're on me, and he's pulling up on you. So, or I should say pulling up on the opponent. But I think it'll be interesting to see both teams compete against each other because they mirror one another so well.
I just want to see the Trailblazers just take one of the first two games. That's I need one of the first two games. It can't happen like it happened against the Rockets. I'm so excited for this series.